Anthony and Doris Burke, our game analysts, and from the sideline, David Aldridge. It's the Chicago Bulls taking on the San Antonio Spurs. All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. So the Bulls five right now. We've got Lister. Lister is out there with Pippen. Then it's Jordan, and it's Ward into the point guard. So it's the Spurs now. The Bulls getting the bucket. Robinson passes to Brown. Plays it up and banks it in. Brown's got his first bucket in this one.
And just showing you his determination, despite the size difference.
I mean, how does he get that shot off? I mean, he had to angle that perfectly to get past the defender.
Chicago shooting their first free throws of this. First free throw is good. And both free throws good for Pippen. On defense, the Bulls. Duncan, a screen. On kicks to Scott. Outside, Robinson. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. Passes it to Scott. Shot clock at five. Here's Duncan. It's deflected, and he recovers it. And it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. Here's Pippen. Pass to Jordan. Shoots over Scott. Nice D from Williams.
Man, with the defense laying off him, you know he's going to pull the trigger. They're lucky he didn't burn him.
It's tipped. And here's the fast break. Jordan leading the way. And slammed up by Jordan.
And guys, got careless with the ball there, and the turnover leads to the big stuff.
Once he came upright with the steal, he went straight on the attack.
Fantastic anticipation. Then he shows major explosiveness, converting at the other end.
Here's Scott. The Bulls getting the butt. Whiteside Robinson. From six away, the seven-footer Lister is there for the rebound. Here's Lister. Robinson with the block. Here's Williams. Again, the miss by the Spurs.
And that's really a function of the offense not working as it should.
Yeah, no, exactly. That's not how you capitalize on the offensive end. You simply have to be more patient.
And here's Brown. After the three-pointer from Scottie Pippen. And it's out of bounds and Spurs as San Antonio retains possession. If you're just tuning in, we play about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Williams a screen. Oh, and a fast break for the Bulls. Jordan slams it in.
And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game.
Well, there's a swagger out there. You can see it on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either. And there's the 3-second call. What's this up? One on the defense. The Spurs shooting their first foul shot of the game. And so he hits the technical free throw. On defense, Chicago. 6-point lead. And again, Chicago running the court in transition. Outside, Pippen launches it. And no good. And it's the Spurs taking it the other way. Williams gets to Brown. Feeds it to Scott. Shot clock at six. Duncan goes in. Tim Duncan scoring inside.
Ooh, just powered it down with both hands. No, he's not going to mess that one up.
No, no, no. He is a superb finisher.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
For Chicago, they have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just 2 for 2. First one falls for it. Hits one, then misses the second attempt for the free throw. Scott against Jordan. He's got a clear path. Oh, he's going up for the alley-oop here.
Oh, what a pass. And then he lays it in with the circus move.
So smooth. Spurs trail by 7. Brown with it. Outside Robinson. Goes up the baseline. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in.
Close.
to Ward. Come with a screen on Williams. Here's Pippen. What a move! Pippen showing off some terrific ball handling.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint there.
There's a screen on Robinson. Spurs have made their only other free throw attempt today in an earlier trip to the line. Here's Ward. Shoots over Bryant. Ward misses. Spurs trail by four. Outside Robinson. Back to Brown. From 10 feet out. Good, and the assist goes to Robinson. Brown's got 5 points so far. Here's Pippen, kept alive. Lister, the fast award, hands it from downtown.
And they can't allow him too many open looks like that. That's just inviting trouble.
Now kicks to Duncan. There's a screen by Robinson. And the whistle blows as the basket counts, and a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up.
Perfect example of how to set a great screen. Set your feet, stand firm.
The Spurs shoot their third free throw shot of the game. And that one misses. The Bulls leading by three. The dish to Jordan. That shot off the mark. Nice D from Scott. Spurs passing it around.
Out of bounds.
Checked is for Chicago. Caspi, he's checked in for Lister. Person comes in for Pippen. And it's Pondex comes in for Michael Jordan. Williams against Percy. On Dexter from outside. Tim Duncan grabs the miss. Duncan's got five rebounds tonight. Here's Robinson, the Admiral, making no mistake on the inside.
He doesn't let that position go to his head. He's going to feed on those second chance opportunities. Boy, that's pretty work.
Caspi, that's for two. Lister controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin. Particularly here to start the game.
Brown outside. That's a hand on it. It's rebounded by Person. Chicago leading by three. Required by Dexter. And the rebound goes to Duncan. Duncan's got six rebounds here tonight. Scott can't get it to go. It's stolen by Duncan. The first quarter all wrapped up, and it's been an exciting game so far. Bulls lead by three, and we'll return shortly. We got a close game here as we get back to the second quarter. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we did? The Bulls leading by three, so for Chicago right now, Williams is out there with Curry, then there's Armstrong. Now there's Caspi, and it's Ward in at the point. Chicago shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game. Free throw drops for Caspi. And both free throws good for Caspi. Here's Davis. Screen by Grant. Dishes to Grant. That's a goal. And the 7-foot-1 Bill Cartwright extends for the rebound. Armstrong with it. Williams picks him up. No good from outside. That's starting for Chicago. They won that game with 8-16. Grant against Williams. They find Jay on the way. Still looking for his first make after that miss. He's 0-2. Cartwright with his to Armstrong. To the inside. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. Cartwright's got the lead up to 7 now for the Bulls.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
There's Jackson with the three. It's good. Great play by Williams to set it up.
And you can see there the defender gets caught up on the pick.
You simply got to push through that, right? You need to at least contest the shot. Otherwise, he's going to knock it down.
That was
for San Antonio. And Caspi gets to Armstrong. Let's it go with the three. And Omri Caspi with the three. And now it's a 10-point Bulls lead. And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game.
And the time right against them needs to talk it over with his guys.
Well, Greg, I think I love the timeout call. At least it gives you a shift in momentum. It's a smart move.
Davis, the pass to Neely. Knocks it loose. Oh, and a fast break to the Bulls. And so he draws the foul on the shot on a trip to the line to shoot two.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
For Chicago, they have shot 5 of 6 at the foul line tonight. Comes in for Williams, and it's Pondexter in for B.J. Armstrong.
And doing a good job from the line here in the second quarter.
A screen by Grant. Over Caspi. They get it again. It's blocked. Grant the pass to Neely. Outside, Davis. Spurs passing it around. Screen by Grant. Down low. Quickback controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Well, the height advantage in this matchup becomes a big factor when he's in the low box.
Here's Pondexter. It's rebounded by Bax. Spurs trail by 10. Outside of Davis. Pass to Neely. Davis dishes to Grant. Shot clock at 5. Tipped away. And in their second quarter, a little over 3.5 minutes played already. The Bulls leading by 10. Deep two from Pondexter, not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down.
Yeah, and their shooting really starting to pick up here in the second.
Cash with the screen. Looked away. Six on the shot clock. Davis in the corner. Here's Neely. And that one falls coming off of Davis.
Timeout.
Neely's got it back down to single digits for San Antonio. And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago. So there's a new procedure for choosing starters in the All-Star Game, Doris. Fans account for 50% of the vote, as you know. Players, 25%. Media, 25%. What do you think of that?
I love that the fans have a vote. I would like to see the percentages changed in this way. I would like players, peers, to have 50% of the vote. Give the media and fans 25% each. So just swap it so that the peers are dictating outcome of the All-Star.
Or even if you just had maybe two players from each team, guys with some respect and some nice perspective to fill that role you're talking.
That's a great point. You pick the leaders from your group and they cast the vote. Perfect.
Really surprising to see the huge edge they have in rebounds given what the scoreboard says.
Brown outside. The feed to Jackson. Back to Brown. Screen by Grant. Over Caspi, and with that, the Chicago lead is cut to just 5 on the basket from Grant.
Looked like some confusion defensively that time. Left him wide open for a nice one-on-one jumper.
From 18 feet away, and again, Chicago, no good. Outside for Jackson. He dishes it to Robinson. Over Caspi, and Robinson knocks down the J.
Boy, his shot looks so much more fluid this quarter. He got a bunch of that clip.
Pippen, he scores with that shot. Now he's 3 of 8.
Boy, Kev, I love his game. He can hurt you in so many different ways.
Out gets to Robinson. That one goes. Count it. Robinson's got 6 in the quarter.
I'll tell you, the feed puts him in prime position to convert. The assist was where it needed to be.
A nice shot by Jordan. Spurs trail by 5. Now and kicks the Jets. And there's the pass to Neely. Back to Jackson. Fishes to Grant. Over Caspi. And he didn't get quite enough under that one.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
3 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Second shot opportunity. And again, it's Michael Jordan.
Yes, sir.
Jordan's got 8 points.
That's a perfect mid-range jumper. All he needs is an inch of space, and they gave it to him.
And it's Jordan with the jam.
And racing up the court, you have a number of options and a great decision there.
I love how he took the initiative, right? He took charge of the opportunity and made the right decision.
Thus far, off the charts. It's only been 2 quarters, just a great effort.
And it's the Bulls with the ball. They've held a 12-point lead earlier. Robinson is out there with Duncan. Then it's Williams. Then there's Brown, and it's Scott in at the two spot. So that's it right now. That starts the second half. And the shot is good.
Defensively, this is what you know. He's coming off a hot game and looking to keep it rolling.
Well, you want to slow this man's roll right now if you're the defense, because you've got to make somebody else beat you. He's cooking right now.
And he comes off the screen to bury the jump shot. Scott's got his second ball.
Well, that's not exactly the most solid screen you'll see, but it still works.
Hippen. Finish off by Lister.
And guys, isn't it great to see a player who works that hard on the glass and go big?
Well, Sedgy, that's the way he has built his reputation. Finding a way, 100% effort all the time.
So much tenacity. Really tries to outwork everyone around him.
And defensively, they're on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Brown kicks to Robinson. Shoots, and there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two. And Chicago called for the foul. The Spurs shooting their fourth and fifth shots at the foul line in the game. And he can't hit the second. Chicago leading by 11. Outside for Pippen. Stolen by Robinson. Pass to Brown. 2 minutes gone in this third quarter now. There's a screen by Robinson. Just fine to shoot. Long kicks to Robinson. Off target from outside.
And a really smart defender there. He just reads the play, wastes no time trying to blow it up.
Almost like he was anticipating the play call, right? You love the hustle.
Here's Jordan. 14 points for him. Scott picks one up.
Even from over here, you can see that one.
Bulls have been coming through at the charity strip. They made 7 of their 8 attempts. Brandon Bass has checked in for Robinson. Spurs trail by 11. San Antonio calls timeout. We've seen Michael Jordan really having a great game.
And he's just attacking the rim with force here. They need to try and deny him the ball in the paint to keep him away from the basket.
Just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. Kicks to Duncan.
What fire at the arc?
Jordan against Scott. Hey. Ball's knocked loose.
Yeah, Jordan.
Now Jordan, he's got 16.
To the big stuff.
Once he came upright with the steal, he went straight on the attack.
Fantastic anticipation. Then he shows major explosiveness converting at the other end.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. And it's good. That bucket takes him to 9 for 14.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Cash with the screen. Bomb kicks to Scott. Here's Duncan. And a foul caught on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. He shot two free throws in the game, made one and missed one. That one misses, so he goes one for two. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Spurs will take it. Spurs trail by 14. Cash with the screen. Knocked away. And that's out of bounds. San Antonio will retain possession. Here's Brown. He has five. He feeds it to Scott. Knocked loose. And here's the fast break. Jordan Lee.
Oh, wow. That's crazy.
That's a beautiful jam.
Well, there you go. One team operating on all cylinders at both ends. Steals, fast break buckets, and the other team in scramble mode.
Here's Bass. Chicago grounds the miss. Lister's got four rebounds in this game. Jordan with Williams picks him up. The drive by Jordan. The shot's good on the assist by Pippen. And now, 24 points for Michael Jordan.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
Tom kicks to Duncan. Scott against Jordan. Five to shoot. And here we go, the Bulls. Jordan on the reverse.
Oh, nice there, getting the reverse. Love that. And the fans got a little bit of a show there.
Guys, that one definitely had a little something extra on it. Pass to Scott. Duncan outside. And Duncan gets double teamed. Back to Scott. An easy 2 points on the layup. Scott's got six here in this quarter.
Boy, you can't pin their struggles today on him. He's been on fire from the field.
Here's Williams, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and two shots coming up.
Clearly a foul.
It's his first trip to the line. The first one falls. He's off on the second. Spurs trail by 19. Not loose. The drive. So it's the Spurs now. Pass with the screen. Brown the pass to Duncan. Jordan with the rebound. Chicago leading by 21. And it's Jordan with the jam.
You know, they barely needed other contributions. This lead has been built through his offense.
Scott kicks to Brown. Back to Scott. Here's the three. The shot comes out, and it's Chicago the other way. Jordan dishes to Pippen. Taken away by Williams. Ball's knocked loose. And here we go. The Bulls fast break. And Pippen slams it in.
And the steal then right into the fast break. Great awareness.
Yes, intercepted the ball in stride. Turnovers like this are devastating to the opposition.
The 3 quarters of play all in the books, and this one all but over already. It's the Bulls. Just welcome back as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. Not exactly a nail biter here, but you never know. Here's Davis on the court for the Bulls, getting this fourth quarter started. Williams is out there with Caspi. Then there's Cartwright. Then it's Jordan. And it's Armstrong in at the one spot. Neely, the pass to Jackson. Shot clock at six. Jones kicks to Jackson. Neely, but he gets it back. And the shot clock expired. 24-second violation. The Bulls making a switch here. Ondexter's checked in.
Yo, who's that, BJ?
Here's Cartwright, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Cartwright's got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for the Bulls. Pass to Neely. Here's Bass. Rebound by the Bulls.
Well, that's a tough defense.
Dexter.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Pass with the screen. Shortening the preseason, adding a week to the regular season to avoid some back-to-backs, Doris. How much is that going to help the players, you think, stay healthy?
You know, this is a fascinating development and one of the areas where the NBA was so proactive in long-term health and well-being of their players. Kevin, I'm anxious to see. Everybody was frustrated by the number of preseason games. They didn't matter. And so I think by taking some of those games that have zero impact on the season, zero impact on how you evaluate and put your team together, is going to be critical to avoiding back-to-backs and the dreaded four games in 5 nights. I'm so excited to see how this plays out.
Of course, we're going to get a better product in the regular season. We're going to see players fresher, less injured. I mean, it's a win-win. And the jam by Bill Cartwright.
Exceptional play across the board. I love their tenacity. Just piling it on at this point.
You know, the beauty is it hasn't just been offense, right? It's been the defensive end as well. They're firing on all cylinders right now.
Got a piece of it. Five to shoot. Here's San Antonio now. They have yet to put up any points during the fourth. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Here's Pondexter. Over Jackson. Pondexter, no good.
Well, obviously, it's been an off night for him offensively, but give his teammates credit. They bailed him out, and he's still got time to turn it around.
Davis kicks the pass. Screened by Jones. Now the pass to Neely. Pocket four. That's tipped. Taken away by Williams. Here's Armstrong. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Williams. Williams has got 3 assists in the game. Here's Davis. Screened by Jones. Davis kicks to Jackson. Tipped away. One-on-one fast break. Here's Pondexter. Here's Williams. It's rebounded by Bass. Bass has got his 5th rebound in this one. Passes it to Neely. And it's Bass atop the key. Here's Davis. No good again that time.
Boy, that's high-impact defense in the lane. Standing tall to deny the easy bucket.
Offensive rebound. Again, Williams missing. So far, we've seen them be a bit careless with the ball.
Simply put, out of control is how they play thus far. They're going to have to reel it in and show some more discipline.
To the paint, feeds it to Caspi. Cartwright, the pass to Caspi. And the Bulls with another miss. And here's the fast break. Shot from 12. Here's Bass. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over.
Really strong rebounding on the interior. He gets the easy putback.
Pondexter, no good.
I tell you, with the struggle he has had today, he's probably won't be their number one option as he looks to close this game out.
And the Spurs making a change here. Scott's checked in. Person's checked in for Chicago. Screened by Jones. Now the dish to Davis. Jones sets the pick for Davis. Softly drops in the floater.
Well, I'll tell you, it takes a lot of confidence to go with the floater. That is not as easy as it looks.
Here's Armstrong. Here's Cartwright. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time.
And you just hate to give up those second chance points.
Well, you better be more physical on the glass because they wanted that rebound more than them. Plain and simple.
Jones with the screen on Armstrong. Here's Neely. Williams.
And really, these are some of the toughest calls an official has to make.
1:43 left here in the fourth quarter.
No three for Person.
But three. And Chuck Person, good for three, the Rifleman.
Boy, he didn't get much separation, nor did he need it. He buries the three.
Well, then I've got.
And by Jones. Outside, Scott. Hits the mark, and he was fouled on the way out. 2 free throws now for him. Of course, not too long ago, changes were made to the intentional foul rule.
Well, I certainly love that the away from the plate fouls were extended to include the last 2 minutes of each period. I don't think you should necessarily
must have been feeling great coming into the building tonight. Because once he hit the court, it was all working for him. He was in a zone.
And with their spot in the postseason assured, he's picking up just at the right time to be on top of his game. Now the Bulls with it. They're on a 16-5 run here. On the wing, Williams. He kicks it to Bondexter. From Pondexter. 23 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Here's Scott. Offensive rebound. Bass can't get it to go. On the wing, Williams. Williams, the big man, gets it to go.
Running up the score, showing no mercy.
At this point, they're overwhelming them. The opposition looks totally defeated.
And so Chicago takes this one, and by a big margin. This one was over well before the final buzzer. The fans were waiting for something to get excited about, Greg, but they never got it.
They sure didn't. I mean, they just rolled to this win. They made it look really easy. What an efficient performance at both ends.
And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.